Welcome to New Beginning Outreach International. We invite you to our services at 12 noon or live at 1205 at slogaroo.com. We also have Breaking Bread Bible Study every other Tuesday at 6:30 p.m. Let's get ready to enjoy the service. Remember to spread love under God's grace everywhere respectfully to rejoice on and on. See you soon.
Such a good thing when you just worship your Lord and worship your King. Hallelujah. My God. Yes, Lord. That's when you give your worship to Him. Your worship to Him. Something with your name on it. He says, the sheep hear my voice, and I call them by name. And leadeth them out. And it says, and when he had put forth his own sheep, he goeth before them. Now this is key. When the Lord does something, he goes before you. Glory to God. He goes before you. And it says, and he and the sheep follow him. Ooh, glory, that's good. So the Lord goes before you, and then we follow him. My God. And it says, for they know his voice. And it says, 5, and a stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him, for they know not the voice of strangers. You know how we teach our young babies, when a stranger comes, stranger danger. You have to call out, stranger danger. Stranger danger, that's not my shepherd, but stranger danger. Glory to God. We got to call these things of what it is. Because you know, nowadays, people are kidnapping kids. And also, you ain't got to be a kid no more, because they kidnapping adults. My God, you look on the milk cart, they say, have you seen my baby lady? My God, have you seen this missing person? Glory to God. And as I was in my office just checking out Facebook, I seen a young man, 30 years old, he's missing since New Year's Eve.
Wow.
Glory to God. So I'm just like, wow, okay, Lord. So now it makes sense. Glory to God. Stuff happens during the new year. My God, things come to an end, but we got to thank God for new beginnings. Glory to God. We got to thank God for when stuff happens. Glory to God. We know the enemy comes into the atmosphere of the world to do things kind of differently and mess your way of thinking up. So you just forget about what you really have to do. My God. And it says this in 6. The parable speaks of Jesus unto these things, and the people didn't understand what he was talking about. Every time Jesus spoke a parable, people didn't understand what he was talking about.
Right.
So he told them, verily, verily, I say unto you, about the sheep, and then about the ones who are coming in, and then the robbers, and then he said, a stranger won't follow. They said, what are you talking about? Then Jesus said again to them, again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. Glory to God. I am the door. Glory to God. So even though we invite you to come in, God is the door. Glory to God. Jesus is the door. I'm not leading you just to New Beginnings Outreach International. I'm just leading you to the door. I'm leading you to the door. Glory to God. I'm ushering you in to the door. Especially on day one. Into the door. It says, by me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved. And he shall go in and out and find pasture. That's what's going on. We all looking for green grass. We looking for the grass. What does it say? Some people say the grass looks greener on the other side. Until you get over there and find out it's just turf. Until you find out it's just turf. Then you find out this grass ain't what it looked to be. They didn't paint this grass. This grass is really burnt orange. Glory to God. But you know, nowadays what people do to get you to buy as consumers, they make it look pretty. And they put different chemicals out there. And they put different things to make the grass look green. I even have guys who come to my house, hey, we want to make sure that your grass looks good. I'm like, okay, well, what's wrong? We can make it even greener. What you going to do? We just want to spray this little chemical down there just so it can grow right. Glory to God. So you got to watch the grass. Find pasture. 10. This is good. The thief cometh but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. And I come that they might have life and that they might have it more what?
Abundantly.
My God. He does that. As we enter the door, that's when stuff happens. Because if you don't go through the door, you jumping over the gate. What it says? You are a thief and a robber. This is what people don't understand. You can't get the blessings of the Lord coming through the gate.
That's right.
You can't do it. You got to go through the door. Got to go through the door. There is, I'm going to put this here real quick before I go any further. There are no shortcuts in God.
Amen.
If you go another way, you're a thief or a robber.
That's Lord.
Amen. That's what the word says. It is not what Pastor Ruth says. That's what the word in red letters. Amen. He says the thief of Jesus, the thief cometh not but to steal. So in 2016, you feel like to come back and call stuff been stolen from you? It ain't God. He came to steal, came to kill, and to destroy. But today is day one. So this is what you need to do. Everything that happened in 2016, you thank God for it and move on. Glory to God. Thank God and move on. It's a new year. Like we say, new grace and new mercy. So if he gives us new grace and new mercy, what can he do for a whole new year? You have to declare and decree things out of your mouth so that things can come to pass in your life. Amen. Amen. See, check this out. In 10 and 11 it says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. My God. He's a good shepherd. As pastors and people of the fivefold ministry, we are under shepherds, under the good shepherd, right? The good shepherd, then the under shepherd. He says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. But he that is an hireling and not the shepherd, whose own sheep are not, seeth a wolf coming and leaveth the sheep and flee. And the wolf catches them and the sheep scatter. My God, my God. It says, the hireling fleeth because he is a hireling and careth not for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know my sheep, and am known of mine. As the Father knoweth me, even so I know the Father, and lay down my life for the sheep. And the other sheep I have, glory to God, which are not of this fold, them also I must bring, and they shall hear my voice, and there shall be one fold and one shepherd. Therefore doeth my Father love me, because I lay down my life, that I might take it again. I may lay down my life, that I may take it again. Glory to God. So if we follow our leader, follow our shepherd, when he laid down his life, let's do what the shepherd do. Let's lay down our life for the gospel so he can bring it up again. Glory to God. Glory to God. Then it says this, no man take it from me, but I lay it down myself. I have the power to lay it down, and I have the power to take it again. Woo! That touched me. It says, this commandment have I received of my Father. If we are supposed to be like God, be Christ-like, like God, glory to God. I'm going to use myself for example. Amen. I stop something, and then I pick it back up, and then do it again. Glory to God. You know, you stop something, or you go, and you put stuff on hold for a moment. I can't do this right now. I got to tend to this. I can't do this right now. I got to tend to this. Glory to God. Then you can pick it back up again. Pick it back up again. I can't do this. I'm going to do this. Glory to God. When you find out your real assignment and what you got to do in your life, you can find out some things you can hold, put on hold, put it on the shelf. Your aspirations, put them on the shelf to get God's kingdom pushed. This is good. Check it out. Lay down your life. We talk about the good shepherd and we talk about the under shepherd. Glory to God. So I want to be like him. I laid down some things for the last 5 years. Whew. Check it out. Check it out. Laid down some things for the last 5 years. Glory to God. Not being a hireling. Not being a hireling. Doing this with no pay for 5 years. Come on. So you know it's real. Listen, you know it's real. Glory to God. You can know it's real when you can do it with no organ. You know it's real, we can do it with no choir. Glory to God. You know it's real, we can do it with no finances to even broadcast your ministry. You know it's real. Because we're leading you to the door. Glory to God. We're leading you to the door. Glory to God. And that's the key. We want this year, day one, to lead you to the door. Because if you go through the door, no matter what's going on outside of you, you already inside of the door. He says, I come to give you abundant life. Abundant life. And that's what the Lord touched my spirit real quick in John 10 and 10. So now last night we had an abbreviation of what we're talking about today. I had 7 minutes. So today I'm going to give you 25. Amen. The possibilities of your possession. The possibilities of your possession. Glory to God. This year go into the year with the good shepherd. Amen. Go through the door. Go through the door. Glory to God. We know the New Beginnings, Outreach International, thanking God for the first Sunday of the month. Glory to God. The first Sunday of the year. Glory to God. We thank God for every moment of 2016. Glory to God. We're not going to be mad about it. Glory to God. We're not going to be mad about it. Glory to God. Glory to God. And we're going to rejoice with those who rejoice, and we're going to mourn with those who mourn. Glory to God. That's what we're supposed to do as people of God, as a community of God, is be there for one another. Right? Be there for one another. Glory to God. Be there when it counts. That's what people want to you to be there when it counts. Because if something happened to you, you want somebody to be there for you. Can I keep it real? You want somebody to be there for you. Glory to God. In your time of need. Be there for you in your going throughs. Be there for you when you are trying to get to where you're supposed to go. Amen. Can I get amen on that one real quick? Glory to God. It says, I know I'm always excited to be in the house of the Lord, amen. Even while I'm hurt, I'm up here getting it in. I'm trying to do what I got to do. Because I know this, and I know this to be true. The Lord is my source. And he's been sustaining me. So if I can use my life as an example to you, as I'm staying in the door, come on inside.
Come on now.
Come on this side. So when everything around the world goes crazy, we can still be in our right mind.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So even if you're not getting paid in your real job, can't pay you for 2 months, you still be in your right mind.
Amen.
What we're trying to let you guys understand is we're following our shepherd.
Yes.
We're following our shepherd. Glory to God. Truly and surely, it's grass greener on the other sides. Glory to God. That it looks like that. But he says, keep on walking. Keep on walking. Then it says this, the year of possession, Deuteronomy 10 and 11. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. I'm saying it. I'm ready. Glory to God. 10 and 11 says, and the Lord said unto me, arise. Arise and take thy journey before the people. We just said before the people, amen. He said this stuff before the people. You know, you got to get some instructions before the people, right? It says that they may go in and possess the land, which I swear unto their fathers to give them. And now, Israel, glory to God, what time is this when they come to that place of the River Jordan? They heard the word of the Lord. He said it told Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So this is a promise that was before them a long period of time. So now when it came to Moses, it came to him and he's ready to possess the land. And we know earlier, like last night, later we'll talk about when he was supposed to speak to the rock. But he hit the rock. Glory to God. So we want to talk about this real quick. Your possibilities of possession.
Yeah.
Possibilities of possession. And the possibility in the definition, it says a chance that something might exist. Okay, well, it might be a chance this year. I may be better than last year. Okay, I know my last year's kind of been better. And our pastor always talk about my next year should be better than my next year, but it ain't happening. But this is the key. There's possibilities if you get in position.
Yeah.
Possibilities if you get in position. We got to take 2017 seriously.
That's right.
Seriously. Make your budgets out, write your stuff out, write what you can do out. Glory to God. Let's take it seriously. My God, take it seriously. So we can go to the next level in your personal life. Amen. As well as your spiritual life. Amen. You want to make sure that you 100% with God. Glory to God. So when trouble comes, I said we ain't talking about storms in 2017. When troubles come, you will be ready. Not storms, because storms is seasonal, or storms are the stuff that we want to talk about. Troubles. Troubles. When troubles come, you can be ready for it. You can be ready for it. Glory to God. So then we talk about the possibilities, a chance that something might exist, something that may happen. It says a fact of being possible. So are you telling me that, Pastor, there's a possibility of me possessing some things? Yes, I am. Yes, I am. All you got to do is be in position.
Amen.
Glory to God. All you got to do is be in position. All you got to do is be ready for your name to be called. Ready for your name to be called. Glory to God. Can you be found working? Glory to God. Until your name gets called. My God. Can you be found working until your name gets called? Glory to God. He says, I come to give you that abundant life. That abundant life. So this is to encourage you all as it encourages me. There is possibilities for you to possess, but you got to make your move. If you was here last night, you heard a little abbreviation of it. You got to make your move. Glory to God. And when I say make your move, you got to get it moving. Faith without works is dead, and it is impossible to please God without faith. So now it's time to come into faith with God. Believe God for some stuff you can't do on your own. That's faith. That's faith. When you believe God enough to do something that you can't do on your own, that's when he comes in.
Yes,
I'm telling you guys by experience, I'm telling you guys this for example, glory to God, because when you do that, you get to the end of yourself, and then God can step in, because he says, they can't handle this on their own, I have to step in and do what I got to do, amen, now check this out, we talked about the four lepers briefly last night, the four lepers, they were at a place that they needed to get something to eat. Glory to God. The whole city was in a famine. The whole place was in a famine. And they needed something to eat. And they had to have a quick little meeting with themselves.
Yeah.
Glory to God. They had a quick meeting with themselves. They said, if we stay here, we're going to die. If we go in, we might die as well. But you got to get to the point to know that I can't stay in 2016 and it's 2017.
Oh, no.
I got to make my move. I can't stay in 20. Because some of us still in 2013. Glory to God. Some of us still in 2013. We got to come to 2017. We got to make our move. We got to make our move. We got to make our move. When we make our move, glory to God, put your best foot forward. Put your best foot, but you got say move.
Move.
You got to move. Glory to God. You got to move. You got to be. Glory to God. What you say you want to be. Glory to God. You got to put it in your mind. We know a lot of theology and people who think in business, they say you got to speak that thing into the atmosphere. You got to write their vision and make it plain. You got to put something on your mirror. I'm beautiful.
Yes.
Glory to God, because it starts in your mind. Sometimes we just have self-esteem. We can't be who we are called to be.
Come on now.
I can't preach. I got a speech impediment. I can't read. I can't preach. I can't make no money. I'm still going through what my mom and them did. These are the things that try to make you feel that you can't be who you are called to be. Glory to God. Those are things that are trying to steal, glory to God, kill and destroy what's inside of you. But you got to stand up to that thing and say, I'm making my move. I'm going this way. My God, I'm going this way. But then you got to find who is on your team. They say you got to look at the five people around you. And that's going to dictate where you're going to be in a few years.
Yeah.
So sometimes when you're looking around, my God, you're looking like, hold up. Ain't none of y'all changing. I can't stay like this no longer. It's time for me to make my move. Because if I don't, I'm going to die right here. Or I'm going to die wherever I go. I'm just going to take a chance to make my move. This is key. That says, when there's no risk, there's no reward. With no risk, there's no reward. This is my philosophy as a man of God. I'm going to give you guys just a secret of how I live. I live like this. First off, I know the Lord is coming back for the church, right? Second, I know I can't take nothing with me if I leave before that, but I'm waiting for the rapture, right? Thirdly, I'm going to do everything I got to do to bring him glory. So what that means is everything I got is not mine. I'm just glory to God. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter because it's not attached to me and I can give it away. Because I can't take nothing with me. So what I do is I say, Lord God, what you want me to do? Let me put myself on the back burner because you know what? I have resurrection in me so I can bring those things back to life. 2017 is in your possession. If you don't believe it, it's just on you. Because I'm going to tell you what happened to a man who didn't believe. Check it out. Second Kings 7, 1 through 2. And Elisha is the prophet. He's the one who had the double portion anointing. Double portion anointing. It says, hear ye the word of the Lord. My God. Thus saith the Lord, tomorrow about this time shall a measure of fine flour be sold for a shekel. And two measures of barley sold for a barley for a shekel. Excuse me. And in the gate of Samaria. So Samaria was going through a drought.
Yeah.
Samaria was going through a drought, and I've been hearing a lot of people since they talking about, you know, we got a new president, it's about to be a drought next year, right? He goes try and dry up some stuff, right?
Yeah.
But that stuff shouldn't affect us because we are the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
Especially if you've been getting your stuff in order, amen. Got to get yourself in order, amen. So it says two. Then the Lord on whose hand the king leaned answered. Of the man of God. So he said when he leaned, that's like his right hand man.
Yes.
This is the king's right hand man who heard what the prophet had said.
Yes.
And he says, behold, if the Lord will make the windows in heaven, might this thing be?
Mm-hmm.
My God. And he said, behold, thou shalt see it with thine eyes, but shall not eat thereof. So he prophesied and said that the prices was going to be very low for the stuff they got going on.
Mm-hmm.
Meaning it's going to be an overflow. So he's like, so what are you saying? You telling me that it's just going to be corn coming down? It's going to be barley coming from heaven? You know how some people would just mock your God? How is going to be the year of possession? Y'all ain't got nobody at church.
Come on.
Listen to this. How you going to do this? And you ain't all T.D. Jakes.
Come on now.
Listen to this. God going to rain down $1 million on you.
Yes.
Check this out. It says, and behold, thou shalt see it with thine eyes, but shalt not eat thereof.
Uh-huh.
So if you don't believe it's going to be in your possession, you're going to see it with your eyes.
Uh-huh.
But you may not eat thereof.
Uh-huh.
My God. So he told that man, and the right-hand man went and told the king. And you know, kings, people in government, check this out, let this bless you. People who are mayors, people who are government officials, glory to God, they think they're king.
Uh-huh.
But but there is a King of Kings who's above them, and us as prophets and mouthpieces of God have to speak to them so they can do what they need to do on the earth.
Amen.
My God, people got it kind of twisted, and this is how it is. The prince of the air makes things differently, so it's harder for us to communicate the things of the gospel.
Amen.
Amen. Check this out. So Elijah the prophet gave a prophetic word, and he says tomorrow. Somebody say tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
My God, my God. It's January 1st already, but check this out. It says, in the commentary, Elijah foretold that Samaria being in bad shape. My God, sometimes we be in bad shape. We need a word from God. Amen, amen. And it says, yet in 24 hours they shall have plenty. It says the king's right-hand man didn't believe that word. He thought it impossible unless God should rain down corn from heaven since there were in a drought. Glory to God. It says unbelief is like a sin. Unbelief is like a sin. I didn't even get a chance to say that last night because I was just doing my abbreviation. But the women of God went forth last night and they talked about all of this stuff that I was saying. Unbelief is like a sin. It told both so come out of sin. Unbelief is like a sin. It says, like the murmurings of Israel, then seeing Canaan, but could not enter in because of their unbelief and their forfeited promise. Do you know some of us forfeit our promise? Some of us are going to forfeit the possession by whatever it is. You just forfeit. It don't matter what you did, you forfeit it. You know how you go to a game and the other team don't show up? It's a forfeited game.
Yeah.
So that's a loss on your record. Woo. Yeah. I don't want to go on to 2018 without my possessions.
Yeah.
I've been waiting on this since 2014.
Uh-huh.
I put some stuff on the back burner. Man, y'all know what I put on the back burner?
Yes.
Like I talked about last night, you give up wife, you give up husband, you give up sister for the gospel.
Uh-huh.
I gave up my personal wants, my personal needs. Glory to God. I'm getting all my stuff this year. Because I laid it down and I got resurrection power to bring it back up.
Yes, yes.
Woo. So listen to this. Pause that. If your pastor about to get his, get yours. You gotta follow the leader, right?
That's right.
Follow the shepherd. If your pastor about to get his, it's time to get yours. We got to come back. We passed that. Woo, glory to God. You know how if you look on your milk and it says expiration date? The comeback has expired December 31st. You can't drink of that no more.
That's right.
It's the possession.
Yes.
It's the possession. Glory to God. And that's how God would do it. Glory to God. He will make you do something that you never thought you would do in your drought. He will do something that you never thought you would do in your drought. Because if it wasn't a drought, desperate measures wouldn't be there.
Come on. Amen.
You wouldn't be looking at your lifelines like you should be when you have plenty.
Yeah.
Woo! It's a blessing. I'm trying to hold my testimonies back. Amen. Glory to God. I'm going to go ahead. I didn't work for the last 8 weeks, right? But when I come back, my shop going to be a little new. Amen. Glory to God. I got a little stuff that's about to be a little new. Praise God. I got some things I'm about to take care of. Glory to God. Because I positioned myself for my 2017. Listen, as you position yourself for your next level, can't nothing stop you. Glory to God. Now I'm prophesying in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare, as you position yourself, there's nothing going to stop you for your year of possession. In the name of Jesus. Check this out. Whether they like it or not, this is your year of possession. This is your year of possession. This is your year of possession. My God, especially if you listen to the words coming out of the prophet's mouth. If you receive that, you should eat of that. Ooh, that's going to be my reflection today. If you receive that, you should eat of that. Oh, Messiah. If you receive that, you shall eat of that. My God, my God. Woo! Shadabasika narabasi. If you receive that, you shall eat of that. My God, my God. We're going to go ahead and flow. I got a few more minutes. Glory to God. And then it says this. In 2 Kings 7 and 3, it says, and there were four leprous men entering in the gate, and they said one to another,
that's right,
why sit here until we die?
That's right.
Why sit there until you die?
Come on now.
Glory to God. Do something. Make your move.
That's
they said,
right.
So they had a meeting. So these people are strategizing their last moments together. They said they had to come up with something and weigh out their options. This year is about to go down because I really have the release to do everything.
Amen.
All my assignments are done. Glory to God. Yes. So now it's time to do everything. Glory to God.
Yes.
And it says we have to weigh out our options. This is what we're going to do in 2017. We're going to get this Outreach International. I'm going to yield myself to you to help you to get to where you need to be. With budgets, with everything. Glory to God. So you can go to your next level. We're going to have sessions and everything this year. Glory to God. Because it can be done. It can be done. We're living proof. Amen. It can be done. Can be done. But we have to be taught. And we have to be willing to be taught. Amen. Willing to be taught so we can go to that next level. Amen. So they had a meeting. They weighed out things. Their best option. Glory to God. And somebody said, well, we have no choice. We have no choice. Glory to God. We have no choice. If we stay here, we're going to die. So we might as well go in. I'm telling you right now, you might as well go in hard. This is the year of possession. You might as well finish out the next 51 Sundays in church. Glory to God. You might as well fill out the next Bible studies, because why not?
Amen.
This year, put God on your calendar. Give God 72 hours of your 2017.
Come on, come on.
Amen. Give God 3 days of your 2017. That's all God is asking. Glory to God. That's all God is asking. I'm gonna pause and put this in here. That's all God is asking. Our requirements was to do some things that we had to do. I really couldn't really set too much things in order because I had to complete these things. But he said, that's all I've been asking for the last 4.5 years. It's 3 days of 365.
Yes, God.
3 days. 3 days. Those are in hours, though. Amen. I just need 72 hours of your time. Because you know what happened in 3 days, right? He died, glory to God, and he rose. He died and he rose. He died. Those things that you didn't think could resurrect, give God 3 days. Give God 3 days of your 2017 and watch God resurrect some things in your life. Now, what is that going to take? Is it going to take commitment? Yes, it is. Is it going to be raising up your expectations? Yes, it is. You might as well. Glory to God. You tried everything anyway. If your 2013 wasn't good, do better. 14 wasn't good, do better. 15, do better. 16, do better. 17, it's my year.
Come on, come on.
It's my ass. Listen, one of these years gotta be yours. And I know that people say that's cliche, but check this out. You decree it and declare it. A lot of the word that we read, it's the same word. But we shout every Sunday like it's a different word. We preach it out of one book with the same word. So is that a cliche? So if I say this is my year, you mad at me because I say this is my year? The Bible in John 10:10 will be the same every day. I'm just saying, you don't got to believe my prophecy for myself. Because I'm going to eat the fruit of what I say.
More fruit.
Yes, Lord. I hear you.
More fruit.
I hear you.
Come on.
Thank you, Jesus. Find it.
Yes, God.
Where you at? Where you at?
We need more fruit. Come on.
Yeah, this is the big Bible. You know, we got the big pages.
That's right. Amen.
Death and life are in the power of the tongue. And they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. 21. So I said, if you receive it, you eat of it. If you speak it, you eat of it. If you spit it out, you're going to regurgitate it. Glory to God. We don't just hold on to the word when trouble comes. We hold on to it when we're walking through. Glory to God. To our next situation. My God, the word of God has to be in your mouth so tough. You got to know the word. Glory to God. Listen, I don't know every scripture verbatim, but I know the word. I know where I can get my help from.
Woo. Come on.
I'm telling you, as we look for the possibilities of possession,
that's right.
All we got to do is look around and see what we can't do it ourselves and allow God to step in. So when we allow God to step in, we can't do it no way. We can't do it no way. So check this out. It says, do you know God is waiting on you to move your feet to get what's yours? God is waiting for you to move. Amen. I'm waiting on you. I'm waiting on you. I'm waiting on you. I stand at the door and knock. Boom, 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 boom. I'm standing in the door and knock. Boom, 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 boom. The world and the whole systems of the United States went through something these last 3 weeks.
Yes.
My God, because every holiday was on a Sunday.
Lord Jesus, come on.
Every holiday was on a Sunday.
That's right.
He's knocking at the door.
Yes.
Do, 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 do. Every holiday was on a Sunday.
Amen. Come on.
So that got people want to do family time.
Yes.
Family time.
That's right.
But did you pray and lay hands on your family?
That's right. Amen.
Did you get your personal anointing oil and lay your hands on your family? I told my wife, I say, as for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord.
Lord Jesus, come on.
Can I pause right here and say this? I'm serving the Lord so much that I could care less what goes on around me. As I'm inside of Him, glory to God, I'm putting my trust in Him because my house shall serve the Lord. And I also got this revelation too in 2017. I'm fine with everybody else doing their own thing. Because I know you may not love my God like I love my God. And there's no ill feelings or nothing, because I'm going to love you how He loved me when I didn't love Him. I love Him now. So this is the key. Love and kindness have I drawn. Missing. That's what people missing. And then if the enemy tricks you, those who are here, to think that we don't love you, you have been misled by a thief. You have been misled by a deceiver. Because we are shepherds of the God's own heart. And for 2017, I'm serving all to Illinois notice. Take us out, y'all. I went through all of what I needed to go through in the past race for now. All of my assignments are done. I gotta do what I gotta do.
The Lord.
It's now. It's time to possess. It's
now. 2017.
It's now. It's now. It's now. So if we make our move in 2017, let's possess the land.
Yes, Lord.
It's your pastor. Come on. I want to thank God for pastoring you. I'm going to let you know on this day, I'm excited for the great exploits we're going to do this year. It will be very strategic, and it's going to be a blessing because it's souls that need to be saved.
Yes, Lord.
And I'm excited. Let's get excited for 2017.
Yeah, we made it.
We are coming from the backside of the mountain.
We made it.
We hear now.
Yes, Lord.
Come on. Look at your neighbor and say, we hear now.
We hear now.
My God.
We my hear Lord. Now. We made it 2017.
Woo.
Lord.
We can do tithes and offer real quick. My God, my God.
Yes.
That was one of those anointings you could walk in tears. Woo. My God. We hear. I serve the enemy notice. I've been watching for a long time, and I've been quiet. Glory to God. I still ain't gonna say nothing. But I'm here now. Oh, glory to God. My God, my God. Great, great days are ahead of us. The year of possession is here. My Lord. My Lord. Listen to this, guys. Whenever your man of God goes up, you go up.
That's right. That's right.
When your man of God goes up, you go up.
Yes.
My Lord, my Lord. I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I thank God for the Holy Ghost. I thank Him for all the leading He's been doing. Hallelujah. Thank God for all the leading He's been doing. I thank God that I follow every instruction. In spite of, my God, in spite of. God met the need every year. And guess what? 2017 was our best year. Glory to God. But you know what? 2017 is about to be our best year. 2016 was our best year. And 2017 about to be our best year. I had decreed and declared after 2014, every year would double. And I'm walking in that. And I speak that over everybody's life in here. 2017 will be double of 2016. If you receive it, you can eat of it. I can't wait to get back to working so I can sow some seed. I don't even know how much money I got. But this is all the money I've been having, some fives and ones. And I'm putting it all in there today. I put my 170 in there last night. Check that out. Let me talk about that. I put my 170 in there last night. I went to my savings at my own house and got my 170 out. My God. I come and I'm giving out of my need. In 2017, we want our church to have a savings in your own house. Amen. In your own house. We about to budget this year like never before.
Yes,
amen, amen.
Yes,
it's about to go down. It's about to go down. We're going to invest into it as well, though, right?
Yes.
Glory to God. We're going to have a session. We're going to invest in it as well.
Amen.
We're going to start participating in the things of God this year.
Yes.
Amen. We're going to get it in. My God, I'm excited. I'm excited. It says, who you love, you support. Amen. Well, thank you guys for your support. We are the team, right?
Yay.
Thank God for you guys' support last year. This year, let's go even harder.
Amen.
We want to get partners this year. Amen. We're praying for partners this year. A part of our ministry, but also others around the country. Yeah. Glory to God. We want to pray for partners so we can really do what we need to do. Thank
Amen.
You, brother. We want to really do what we want to do. Glory to God. That's going to take seed to do it. Amen. That's what our 170 is for. Glory to God. It's going into the 2017. We've been doing that for 3 years now. Praise God. Last year, I think we had rose $2,020. Hallelujah. This year, we're going for the same three. We've been going for this. This is the key, guys. We've been going for the same thing every year.
Yeah.
I did nothing different. Amen. We do a sacrificial year. This year, I took down the little calendars that says let's do our June seed and our October seed. Amen. But if you notice, a lot of times I've been doing stuff, I've just been stopping it and keeping it moving. Amen.
Amen.
Because I had to stay with the vision. Glory to God. A lot of people are like, man, why this ain't going on? We don't have that yet. Hey, why this ain't going on? We don't have that yet. We have to get to a place where we can have it and it can stay. Amen. So when we have it, they can count on it. Amen. But this is the key. I was telling my wife, I said, man, the Lord has blessed us. For somebody who doesn't have grants, for someone who doesn't have all of these extra stuff, we just tied it off.
Come on.
We are still running proficiently. Amen. Last night we had an issue with that little bathrooms, but then we came in this morning, no issue.
Try God.
I'm thinking Monday. I'm like, Lord, I gotta see if he got that. That was last year. My God. I'm thinking on Monday, I was like, well, I gotta get something going on. Because the water, when you flush the toilet, the water would come out the drain of the floor. And I'm like, what is that?
That's,
you know, Tuesday,
right.
They some water back here and shut off the water. So I don't know if that was just back up, but I'm like, Lord, service tomorrow, we're gonna have to do something different. But man, I thank God, man. That was last year. That was good. So your troubles is about to go down the drain because that's last year. Your troubles is about to go down the drain because that's last year. Woo, check this out. The stuff that's turned the backbone up, that was last year. Because sometimes you don't have the sewer back up. Just full of mess. But that was last year. That's going to go down the drain.
Come on.
That's going to go down the drain.
Lord,
I'm excited. You guys should be excited because I'm excited. I'm doing a lot of stuff different this year. Personally, I'm going to testify real quick. And then we're going to go forward. I'm going to do a lot of stuff differently in my own life. And I'm excited.
Come on.
Because listen, guys, if you could trust God with everything you have, even when you do less of what you're supposed to do, he will add more to you. For the last 2 years, I've been doing things differently, trying to get some time back.
That's right.
Because we know that I'm a pastor, but I'm a barber as well. And I work very hard. I only took off in the last 7 years, 14 days. In the year to come back, God gave me a lot of time to rest. He restored the years. Check this out. I haven't had a day off. My 13th day off was November 5th. And my 14th day off was November 5th, I do believe. And my wife and them, they went to see my son. I said, I just need to take a day off. I just need to ride my bike and just relax, you know. And then the next week, I got hurt, right? So we took a 2-week vacation. And that was, seemed like the Lord was giving me days and weeks equivalent. So I only took off 14 days, but the year of 2016, he gave me 14 weeks off to rest.
That's right. Amen.
2 Chronicles 7 and 14. He said, if my people will seek my face, humble themselves, and pray. I did so much praying while I've been on my back the last 52 days. Your pastor has been on a fast like none other. I usually lay prostrate,
Lord,
but I had no other way but to lay on my back and look up.
Look
to the hills from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. So as I'm just laying on my back and just praying unto the Lord and asking him for a direction,
Lord,
it's about to be a blessing.
Come on.
A lot of stuff I couldn't do, but now I can do. And I'm excited. I'm excited. I'm resting. I'm still, Thursday make my 8th week, so I'm still going through my process.
That's
but I gotta
right.
fight
Amen.
My way back to
Come
Sovereign Rule. Amen.
Yes, yes.
Because any time off, I gotta be up. Amen. So this year, pray for your boy. Pray for your pastor. And when I go back to work, I'm gonna work even less than that. Amen.
That's so right.
My
You're
work,
doing
I'm working probably like 2 or 4 hours a week. Amen. So I'm gonna work Wednesday through Saturday. Amen. 2 years ago, the Lord said, take a mountain experience on Tuesdays.
That's right.
So every Tuesday, I would take off. If it wasn't Bible study, I would take off and I would go do some stuff.
That's
so as
right.
I've been in my reading, the Lord has really been touching
Lord
my heart
Jesus.
And learning about personal Sabbaths and rest days that I take. So instead of taking every other, I just going to take every Tuesday off.
Amen.
So I could be with the Lord, so I can have 3-4 days of working, only 24
Amen.
Hours a week,
Lord
and
Jesus.
3 days with the Lord. Amen. As I can do other stuff. And listen, ain't nothing gonna change though. You know what I'm saying? This is the key. As I've been decreasing my workload, everything has been the same because I've been decreasing my debt.
Holy Spirit, come on.
Check it out. So I'm gonna pay my truck off, right? And that's gonna give me a pay raise.
Amen.
Come on, come on. That's how we get our raises. If our job don't get a raise, let me pay some debt off and give a raise to myself.
Yeah, we can do that too.
Ooh. I'm telling you, this is an anointing that I have got these last 52 days. It's going to be a blessing. And 52 days is 52 weeks.
Lord. Amen.
Come on. If we just pay attention to this. So today, January 1st, is my 52nd day in recovery. We know about Nehemiah. It took them 52 days to rebuild the wall. And he said, I'm not coming down.
Hallelujah.
This stuff means something to me.
Lord, come on.
I pay attention to dates and numbers and all of that stuff. Not in numerology, but just for it to be consistent with great history facts in the word. Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Glory to God. We're going to pray for this real quick, and then we're going to do our offering.
Givelify is giving simplified. Givelify is the fastest and easiest way to donate to the church, charity, or cause of your choice. You're not limited to the cash you have on hand. There's no need to write checks, and there are no complicated sign-up forms to fill out, websites, or text message codes to remember. Givelify automatically pinpoints your location and intelligently identifies the fundraiser or church service you're attending without the need to search. Since Givelify automatically detects where you are, making a donation can be completed in as few as 3 taps. Tap 1, use one of the pre-configured denominations to specify the donation amount. Tap 2, select the specific campaign to which you'd like to contribute. Tap 3, with your stored credit card, complete your donation in 1 tap. You get an immediate donation receipt, and you can even share your generosity on Facebook or Twitter. Givelify lets you easily see your donation history with any church or charity you donate to. You can also accurately track your donations for your taxes without needing to hunt down receipts, bank statements, or acknowledgement letters. You can also set your home and favorites. Mark churches as your favorites so you can donate as frequently and generously as you'd like, even when you're thousands of miles away. Mark the church you normally attend as your home church for quick one-tap access. Givelify. Tap. Give. Done.